I've made around 100 games so far, and here's the earliest picture of me making one. Striking use of colors, little me. From there, I started a journey of making games. A ton of them I've never shared here before, so I thought maybe we could learn from them and laugh at them. Some are good, and some are really bad. But only one of them was my first game. There are three candidates for my first game. At first, I thought my first game was The Button Game, because The Button Game is my earliest game in Flash, and it definitely qualifies as a game. It's got controls, gameplay, and a lose condition. It's even way ahead of its time and has accessibility options. Press spacebar to take a handbrake. How nice. It does subtract a single point every time you use that, so you gotta be careful about holding the spacebar and getting a negative score. Strangely, I even added a way to change the high score, but you can only change it up to 999 to, I guess, avoid cheating. It's very confusing. But The Button Game isn't my first game. Turns out I made a slideshow, yes, a slideshow presentation in Microsoft PowerPoint that, honestly, is more of a game than The Button Game. Ah, Alex Productions. You can tell it's a game because it has a splash screen. Oh, and a loading bar. Look, it even pretends to stagger like a real loading bar. Alright, the main menu. Let's learn how to play.
Click the play button to start. God. That was easy enough.
Okay, hold on. Spoilers. Let's just play it. Alright. This is the ball. You have to avoid it, otherwise it sends you to the fail PowerPoint slide. So far it's pretty easy. Can't get me. It's trying. It can't, though. Oh. Alright, now it's impossible to see. This doesn't make good Let's Play content. I should have thought about that 18 years ago. Oh. Oh no, the decoys! Which one is which? Okay. Phew. If they stayed, I would have never been able to survive. You can't get me. Oh! Oh no, the background! It's growing! Honestly, this is creative. It's truly a game. I mean, this might be actually hard if it was, like, faster and more circles, but... I think it just loops here. There's no end screen, so... I'm not sure how many people could say they made their first game in PowerPoint. But it definitely qualifies, right? It has controls, gameplay, a lose condition, checks all the boxes. But that might also not be my first game. Have you ever heard of AppleScript? My first computer had no internet. I could play like Freddy Fish and Sim Safari. So on a fair few occasions, I got bored and just open every single folder drop down on the computer. Look, entertainment was scarce back then. And doing this, I stumbled into a folder full of AppleScript examples. And the scripting language was so simple to figure out that I ended up writing this poetry.
Display the dialogue.
How many times do you want to be?
And if you run it, a dialog appears where you can enter a number. And if you enter a 3, for example, it does this.
Beeping 3 times.
Amazing. Controls, check. Gameplay, check. Lose condition, check. Wait, a lose condition? Well, I remember when I wrote the script, I thought it would be funny to do this.
Beeping 5 million times.
Yeah. I had to restart the computer. That's totally a lose condition, right? At some point, I did start working on a digital pet simulator in AppleScript, which would have definitely qualified as a game if I actually finished it. All the save data was stored in file names on the desktop, but the full project was definitely too ambitious for little old me. But 19 years later, hey, I figured it out. So here it is, a simple AppleScript pet simulator. All right, what do we want to name it? Tofu the chicken, of course. And it's so happy to see us. All right, let's start with play. All right, we played Minecraft with Tofu. All right, let's give Tofu some food. Corn on the cob. All right, let's pet tofu. We scratched behind the chicken's ear how thankful tofu is. Tofu's wanting to go to bed. So it updated all the folder names, so if you restart the game, it remembers tofu and all of its stats. One incredible thing about AppleScript is you could place your script in a folder called speakable items. And if you said the file name out loud at your computer, it'd run whatever's in your script. Doesn't that seem like super futuristic for 1993? Making stuff with AppleScript was super discoverable back then, so it's definitely no wonder that I got into game dev because of it. So if there's one thing you can learn about this episode of Game Dev Origins, it's that anything can be a game if you're inspired enough. Buttons, PowerPoint presentations, dialogues, heck, even a piece of paper is a game engine. Uh-oh. All right, we'll dive into a lot more in this YouTube series, which ends on my 30th birthday, marking 20 years of game dev. So thanks to the patrons who supported this episode, and I'll see ya in the next one. Bye.